Hi everyone, Cody here. So I'm up here in the rock slides up by my house. We call this area the Seven because the rocks are kind of in the shape of a seven. And there's these wild cherry trees growing here, the choke cherries. And I figured that since these are growing here, maybe they're getting some water off the rocks or something, maybe I could actually grow some fruit trees. So I got a couple of actual domestic cherry trees growing in here. And I just brought them some water. I try to bring them like a gallon a day. And they're still alive a month later. So maybe they'll grow. I've never been able to grow a cherry tree anywhere else around here. Anyway, I've only got a couple of days before I head off to California and go pick up my girlfriend. I want to go gold panning and maybe do a few videos while I'm down there. So you guys can look forward to that. Anyway, I'm over here by this beehive. Let's have a look at this real quick. Just pop the lid and look in here. Yeah, they're coming along nicely. Looks like they need a cover over top of the bee so they quit building comb against it, but yeah. Looks pretty good. Looks like I'm gonna need to add another couple of frames here pretty quick, actually. So, it's a little update. Let's go look at that torch real quick, shall we? Alright, so here's the torch set up. Yesterday when I unhooked this, I measured it at 80 psi in the hydrogen, and there was about 40 psi in the oxygen. Let's go ahead and check these and see if it's stable. And if it's like lost any, then I'll know there's a leak. 40 psi in the oxygen side, that's good, no leaks there. Let's check the hydrogen. Oh, look at that. That's only like 30. So there's definitely a hydrogen leak. And hydrogen's so slippery, the molecule's so small, it goes through the tiniest of holes. It could be leaking through this gasket, it could be leaking out through a pinhole, could be coming out of the shorter valve. It's really hard to tell. I'll have to go stick it under a tank of water and see where it's leaking out at. All right, well, I've still got gas. I'm gonna try something. Now this torch head right here, I normally wouldn't be able to cut steel, just for welding. But hydrogen will burn with extra oxygen. Like if you had an oxyacetylene torch with a welding tip on it, it would just blow the torch out when you've turned up the oxygen. So you really can't cut through steel. But hydrogen might actually stay lit. So I'm gonna try actually to cut through this piece of steel. And especially since I've got extra oxygen, I think this might actually work. I think that's burning. Yep. The hydrogen flame, especially since I've got it so clean now, I got rid of all that propane, is now completely invisible. I don't know if you can see. You can see its shadow, you can see the flame burning there. This is actually a problem for me, because how do I know when I've got it adjusted correctly? Alright, I got it hot. Let's go ahead and turn up the oxygen. Oh yeah, look at that. Staying lit. It actually worked. It's very crude. You can do a lot better with a torch that's actually designed for it, but it actually works. I think the reason is because hydrogen is such thermally conductive and has such a low ignition temperature that the hydrogen is actually able to stay burning even with all that extra oxygen. So it's able to maintain the flame as I push through it. That's pretty cool. Let's try actually welding something now. The torch is very hard to set because I couldn't see the flame, but I think I got it. See, it's not the best weld ever, but it's on there. You know, it holds. Can bend it and it stays put. So I think it works. Let's see if I can melt something that I normally wouldn't be able to melt. Say, tungsten. I think it's melted. Yeah, I melted the end off of it. Have any idea how hot that had to be to melt that? Woo-wee! I almost forgot, but to finish up this project, I wanted to try burning some of the hydrogen with oxygen. And as you know, when hydrogen and oxygen burns, it makes water. So I wanted to try seeing if I could make some drinkable water.
by burning the gas from this torch. That way it goes full circle. I went from water to gas, and hopefully water again. So hopefully it doesn't break my jar. Oh yeah, I can see it's already clouding up from the water that's forming. Jar's getting hot. I'm definitely collecting the water though. Look at this, I got a drop of water. If you can see it. There we go. See if I can get some of that out of there. A drop of that water on my finger, see that? Yeah, it tastes like water. Distilled water. What's cool about that is actually it's depleted in deuterium. So you would actually be able to chemically analyze this water and tell that it's different than normal water that you'd find. That is cool.
Let's go ahead and see how much gas I used during all that. So it looks like I used about 10 psi of the oxygen. Used quite a bit of oxygen, I guess. And the hydrogen is, I don't even know. But, you know, there's still a lot of improvements. The thing I like is now these tanks, I could just go put them back in the shed, hook them up to that thing, and they'd get refilled. So it doesn't really matter how much I use. I've got an unlimited supply of gas. I think that's pretty cool.
To finish up, I thought I'd show you my idea for another way to make potassium nitrate, or in this case, pure nitric acid. You see, I've got this transformer here that I bought at a thrift store for $12. They didn't know what it was, but I did. This thing turns 120 volts into 19,000. So I can actually jump a 2-inch gap if I wanted. Yeah, so I just got a little spark going in there between those two wires. See that? Now that spark is generating a lot of heat and it's breaking apart the air molecules. And when they recombine, sometimes the oxygen will combine with the nitrogen, forming nitrogen dioxide. This, when it combines with water, turns into nitric acid. Okay, let's unhook this. I just let the thing go for a few seconds inside this jar. Now if I go against something white, you should be able to see that the color of the gas inside the jar is now a light reddish brown. See that? That's the nitrogen dioxide that formed. Now I've got a little bit of water in there, see that? I'm gonna let that water absorb that nitrogen dioxide for a few minutes, and then I'm gonna drop a piece of calcium carbonate in there and see if it reacts with it. If it does, I'll know it's an acid. Probably nitric acid. Okay, so I completed that process a few times. Let's go ahead and see if I made any nitric acid during that process. So I'm gonna drop this piece of calcium carbonate in there. Let's see what it does. Okay, I can't see anything yet. Oh, it's bubbling. Oh, look at that, it's actually bubbling. Come on, camera, focus. Now look at that, it's bubbling. That means I had nitric acid. So that actually works. Yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and set this thing up with an automated system. Maybe something that'll turn on when the solar panels are producing a lot of heat. That'll use up a little bit of extra power. Maybe I'll be able to make some nitric acid while I'm at it. Yeah, that's cool. All right, hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next time. There it is.